Look how beautiful are these colors. I love it.
But I want to show you something.
See this, this is the same photo, same editing, everything the same. But here on my laptop screen looks cold with blue magenta tint. And this as well, this is the same photo, exactly the same, same editing. But here on the computer screen look warm with yellow or green tint.
And here on my mobile it looks blue. How could this happen? Okay, now I'll show you how does this happen and three ways on how to get your monitor calibrated with or without calibrating device. And later on in this video, I'll be showing you before and after and side-by-side comparison. Before and after we calibrate the monitor, how does the colors really change? And that will blow your mind. So make sure to stick around, as I promise you, this video is going to be so helpful for content creators. Mainly, this is because of the screen color temperature. And this is not something only visually that will disturb us while we're editing. This is something will affect our project really bad. Laptop screens like this most of the time comes with cold colors and blue magenta tint. If you're editing your project on a laptop, when you view the end result on other devices or you print it out, it's going to look warm and yellowish, and it's not going to look the way you expected. Consumer PC monitor comes most of the times with warm colors and little bit yellowish. And if you are editing on uncalibrated consumer PC screen, when you view your work on other devices or print it out, it's going to look cold and bluish. One more thing to watch out: brightness and contrast. If your screen is so bright, your work is going to look lack of brightness and dim. If your screen is too contrasty, your work is going to look lack of contrast and faded. First way to solve this, if you have the budget, just use ready calibrated monitor or use Apple product. Apple Mac Pro, Apple iPhone, they are 95% calibrated ready out of the box. Second way is to calibrate your monitor manually. Every Windows has color calibration software installed in, and you'll be able to calibrate your monitor, but that requires some eyeballing. So I recommend you to have one of your photos printed and match it with the screen while you are calibrating. That will give you the most accurate calibration. Let me show you how. I'll be using this print as a reference to calibrate this monitor. As you see, this monitor is too blue compared to the print. When you do a reference print, make sure to do it at professional printing office to have the most accurate colors. And now let's start calibrating. Look for calibrate display color, and then follow the steps. That's too easy. Next. Next. This is to calibrate the gamma of the screen. And this is my screen gamma looks okay. I will not touch it. Next. This is here to set the brightness and contrast of the screen. But since I'm using laptop and we keep change the brightness of the laptop, I will just keep it as it is. I will skip this. Now here is an example of the grays and how is it when it's too red or too green or too blue, whatever. So this is just an example for you to know what you're doing. Let's go next. And here where we will start calibrating our colors. I will make this window small. I'll put it here on the sides. And I have my photo and the reference photo. I have to match them together. Since my screen is too cold and blue, I will start here with the blue slide. I will pull it down until I get the highlights in this area a little bit warm, exactly like how it is in the reference photo. We'll start adjusting the blues. I think this is good like this. And now we'll start adjusting the reds and greens until we match our reference photo. I think the greens are fine, the blues are fine, the red are fine, everything is good now. So I think the photo is good now. This is how I like it. I hope my camera is able to capture exactly what I see now, because this one is backlit and this one is lit by the light over here. And click next, and now it will show us previous calibration and current calibration. So if we put the photos now beside each other and we say previous, look how it was, that's amazing. And now the current calibration. This is the manual way to calibrate your monitor. This is the best way to have reference photo. I saw many other tutorials, but nobody has reference photo and eyeballing is always a problem. Then we click finish and we are done. And finally, the third and the most accurate way to calibrate the colors of your monitor is to get one of these devices. This is monitor color calibration device. This is from Spyder. There are so many other brands in the market, but I found that the most recommended one is the Spyder or the Color Monkey. This video is not sponsored. This is my own device. I'm just sharing with you the information. I'm not going to make full tutorial about this. There are so many tutorials online, but I'm going to tell you how does this work. This device has one sensor from here and one sensor from inside. This sensor will measure the ambient light and the sensor here will read the screen. Now I'll turn off this light to start calibrating using the Spyder. I will choose recalibration. Now the software is asking me to place the Spyder here. And now start calibrating. Calibration is done. Click finish. And open the light again to see the reference photo and the difference. I'll remove the Spyder. We'll save the profile. Next. And now this is the proof of the calibration. See how amazing is this. Before, after. Before, after, before and after. Hope this camera is able to capture the difference, and look how amazing is that. Before, after. Let's see all the screens side by side before and after calibration. This is now uncalibrated. As you see, the laptop screen is cold and blue. The computer screen is warm and yellow. And this is the accurate colors on the print. Let's see how is it after calibration. This is now the view after calibrating with the Spyder. Look how it looks all the same. All they have accurate colors, and that's the benefit of having your screens calibrated. You'll have accurate colors and what you see is what you will get. And that's it. This is how to calibrate your monitor. This is really recommended. This will change your life, will change your career, and will give you confidence while you are editing. So hope this video was useful, hope you like it, and if you did, you know what to do, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers, bye.